I'm Mariana Atencio, and I'm here with Rachel Silverstein, your Miami water keeper. Aquí estoy con Rachel Silverstein, la protectora del agua de Miami. We're, of course, continuing our bilingual series to inform our community here about climate issues that affect us all. Estamos continuando nuestra videoserie en inglés y en español para ustedes, para nuestra comunidad. Rachel, we're here in front of Biscayne Bay. Biscayne Bay is an inlet that is almost the length of Miami-Dade County. We're talking about 220 miles, such rich biodiversity, but it's under threat. La Bahía de Biscayne, una de las más famosas del mundo como bahía tropical, pero está bajo amenaza. Cuéntanos por qué.
Yes, Biscayne Bay is a jewel for Miami. It's what our city's built around. It's our economy, it's our culture, it's our environment, and it's all specially protected by either the state or the federal government. Many people don't know that Miami-Dade County actually is the only county in the United States with two national parks. We have Biscayne National Park, that's 98% marine, Biscayne Bay, and of course Everglades National Park. And it is a recognition on a national scale of how special these places are, but they're unfortunately also declining. So we have lost over 90% in some areas of our seagrass, our mangroves, our coral reefs just offshore. And most of it is because of pollution coming from the land, getting into the water and killing off these natural ecosystems. And that pollution is actually being made worse by sea level rise and climate change impacts too.
That's crazy, 90%. O sea, se ha perdido a veces hasta el 90% de toda esta biodiversidad que hace que la Bahía de Miami sea la Bahía de Miami. We've seen how the degradation of water also has generated events like the devastating 2020 fish kill. What is the waterkeeper's response to that? ¿Cuál ha sido la respuesta de Miami Waterkeeper a estas amenazas?
So we saw in 2020 over 27,000 fish and other wildlife run out of oxygen in Biscayne Bay. It no longer supported life, it had no air left, and they literally died overnight. We're trying to prevent this from happening again by getting to the root cause issue of what happened in that fish kill. And that is limiting pollution. Pollution specifically coming from land, from septic tanks, from storm water, from sewage leaks, and of course from fertilizer. And that's all bringing pollution that's killing Biscayne Bay that we're trying to limit.
Es una combinación de factores que dieron pie a eso, pero entre esos, por ejemplo, cosa que yo no sabía, el fertilizante de muchas de nuestras casas y jardines que termina aquí. Rachel, I know that it's a holistic approach that you guys have taken, comprehensive, and we'll get into that in the rest of our video series. But for now, folks can actually take action by watching this video, sharing and amplifying the message, right?
Absolutely. Get involved, check out our website, follow us, and learn more about how to protect Biscayne Bay.
Remember,
protect the water you love.
Protejan el agua que aman. Gracias.
Adiós, agua amigos.